Hello everyone and welcome back to another episode of Dark Souls 2 PvP Duels. Harry shit! Woo! PvP Duels, you may ask. What the fuck is going on Cornette's channel? Reason behind this shit talk here is because I haven't had a PvP Duels episode since ages ago. Since Jutta's episode, and today I'm fighting against Alex. Alex, a good friend of mine. Maybe the best friend online of mine. He is fighting since ages with this executioner build. He really did a good job at building this build that it's quite ordinary and not something everyone uses in terms of weapons and armor setup and stats. Ooh, that damage! And you may have seen the PvP session with him where you can hear him talk, and I also fight against this build of him with my Paladin Leroy cosplay. And there I go. Flawless win of him. GG. There he had the same build and the same character basically, but he didn't have the Drake Keeper's trade sword and the crossbow, the Sanctum crossbow, in his in his setup included. And I thought it's like a really, really good improvement for his character, because it really became unpredictable and really hard to fight against it with these changes. In the last video, in the PvP session episode, where I fought with Leroy against him, he had he was like the biggest danger of his build was underestimating it, because I knew he was pretty OP with this thing. Yeah, Alex, it is OP, and because could have just one-hit comboed me with his buffed-up Dragon Tooth. And now it's basically that he's really unpredictable, and because the biggest danger of this build was the underestimation, because if I fight long against this build, the Dragon Tooth has a really predictable setup. You see almost all attacks of it coming. And it's really easy to roll around and backstab or backhop and do an attack. And that was the, like I said, the biggest danger of it. Underestimating it, wanting to parry it, or wanting to do something really cool against it. And then he would just wreck your face with one combo. And that's not the case anymore. You really have to watch out what he does, because he has his hexes like you see here, he has his Drake Keeper sword, straight sword, his Dragon Tooth buffed up, and his crossbow. And these three weapons with different movesets and timings are really hard to fight against. And I really had lots of fun. And this fist here is really fucking OP. It's not upgraded, but that doesn't matter at the Bone Fist, because it has, I think, only like 20 base damage or so, but therefore an A and B scaling, so perfect for high level PvP scrubs. And there it was lag, and I was like, oh no, don't attack him. And of course he attacked me instantly in the lag. And so we both died. And here I don't know what the fuck I did there. I just spammed L1, because in the previous fight I noticed it does so much damage. But he wrecked my ass. And that free aiming though, yay, pretty good. And I was like, oh god, what the fuck, he's buffing up and having this thing, and whoa. Yeah, we had some lag spikes, but in the other things where no lag was, we were quite lag free pretty much. And it was like in the first fight where I really prediction parity's first running attack with the. Oh, here again I'm lag and I stopped, but he attacked me with his crossbow. Maybe he didn't notice the lag, but yeah. Also, I used this. I didn't talk much about my build. Oh, whoa. So, like you see here, the armor setup is almost the same as at my Abyss Knight build, but it uses the curved Nil greatsword. Pretty good hit there with the crossbow. The curved Nil greatsword, which scales with your bonfire slit in your world, I think. We are not sure in the Souls community. And it is really fucking good. It's like the two-handed thing, yes. The two-handed animations are the same as the Murakumo animations in Dark Souls 1, like this R1-like swings from right to left and from left to right, and it is almost a guaranteed stagger. Two-hit stagger, and it's quite cool. It's really quite cool weapon, and the damage is insane on New Game Plus and further there. And I also use this ivory straight sword, I think is it, which is like just so, such a ivory tooth, just a small tooth, which triggers a magic. I think it's magic, maybe it's something else. Magic damage. Thing. The downside of this weapon is that it has really no fucking stagger. No stagger at all. If you hit purely with the magic, it will not stagger your opponent quite well. And it's really bad. In the offhand I have the Bone Fist, which I talked a bit about it. The moveset is quite ridiculous. Everyone is using it right now in PvP, but it's not that good. We will get used to it. To fight against it really fast. And yeah, so the curved Nil greatsword has also a spin to win attack on the R2 and L2 two-handed, which I don't use quite often. I almost never use. I used it one time and there I didn't hit it, because the R2 spin attack is a double spin and it's quite it's predictable and really really easy to punish and to see. So really slow wind up of this attack. It's not like the Hellbot spin to win, where you just are completely running at your opponent and suddenly you start spinning around three times. It's not, it's really a long wind up. And the L2 two-handed is like a spin in the other direction, but one spin only. And this is also a really high wind-up timing, and I don't think it's quite that good. So I just use the R1s, which are most times one-handed, and this is quite cool. Also with this ivory straight sword you can do this attack animation cancels, where you basically then roll with a buffed-up sword. Which looks cool. You can do this with the Leom Lois and the Ivory King Ultra Greatsword too. But yeah. There I got a counter roll backstab, which is like my signature move. If you know me, maybe someone else does this too, but not in this form, like perfection. Yay. So backstab fishers do not have a good time against me, I think. Maybe I'm completely wrong and this is like the silliest move ever, but who knows? Write it in the comments if you like this move. And here he just tried to parry my my guard break, which I did often too. And this was a well-timed running attack. Normally you won't hit the running attacks of the ultra great weapons that easy, but if you see, I saw him coming and then I came. Here I failed the counter roll backstab, but before I saw him coming with the running attack and backtop really early so that I could land the running attack before he could roll away. It's like the here you saw that no stagger at all, no stagger. I would really be interested in what thing the what here. No, it's not here. What poise break this thing has. What poise damage. So later we have a the Bone Fist has this drop kick attack for those who watch wrestling things. I watched it earlier, but here, I think, no, not. I will comment on this when it's finally here. This was a phantom hit, ladies and gentlemen, buggy on Dark Souls. And at this point I knew his moves quite well. He's going to do a rolling attack and then a roll and then a rolling attack with his straight sword, because that's quite fast. So I thought, like, roll on me and I'm gonna parry this next time. Also, he's going to run away and either damage you with his crossbow or do the run attack. Here, you saw that. Roll towards me, directly towards me. Was so sure that he's gonna do that, but he didn't. And then he did another roll, and at that point I knew he would do this. He could also not done this thing, but here we just counter backstab each other, almost. But yeah, I was still, and that was also that thing that I did at the beginning of the video. I fought him against him a bit, two fights or so, and I noticed him almost every time starting the fight off with a running attack, and then I thought, like, alright, do your normal running attack. He runs, and then I thought, like, and now the parry, and then I got it. So, and also, I didn't say it now, but curved swords in general and the curved Nilgrade sword is the most ridiculous backstab critical damage in the world, in the game. Yep. So, all in all, I really enjoyed the fights against Alex this time also, like last time, like every time, and his build became really viable, and he also wants to fight against Jutas with this build, so I think he would have good chances. So, that was the last fight. I hope you enjoyed this episode. Leave a like or comment in the comment box below what do you think of Alex's build and my build, and share this video to help grow my channel growing, and I see you all in the next one. Bye bye.